Hello, my name is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com, and today we're here to show you the next greatest plugin to assist you in your content creation, mKeynote. mKeynote is a set of powerful tools designed for multiple purposes. mKeynote includes 8 backgrounds to be the perfect backdrop for your videos, 6 boards to give you useful details about what you are showing. We have 10 calls to action to get the attention and clicks from your viewers. We have 17 infographics to help you visually display information and data. And then we have 3 logo animations to make your logo stand out and look professional. 8 miscellaneous tools, including clocks, tags, and progress bars. We have 15 placeholders that are fully customizable, allowing you to populate them with your content. 28 typography presets that can display information and help tie the style together, and 8 transitions to give you that stylistic keynote transitions look we've all come to love. All right, now that we've gotten an overview, let's head over to DaVinci Resolve. Patrick, take it away.
Thanks, George, for that introduction. We have a lot to cover, so let's get started. Inside DaVinci Resolve, all mKeynote content can be found inside the Effects tab. mKeynote includes a wide variety of content, including transitions, titles, and effects, all stored in their respective folders. The best way to display all the presets at once is to click on Toolbox and type in the search field mKeynote. This will show you all mKeynote content regardless of how it's organized. By skimming the cursor over the thumbnails, you will be able to preview each preset. You can also add any preset to your favorites by clicking the star icon to the immediate right of each preset name. To start, I will add title number 2 onto my first clip. I can simply drag and drop the title over the clip and adjust the duration to my preferred length. To edit the title, I will select it and open the Inspector tab. Each preset has their own dedicated parameters, with most of them including this option to toggle on and off the in and out animation. For this title, we have content controls, text controls, and elements controls. First, I will edit the text inside the text controls. I'm going to type in new MacBook. Then inside the content controls, I will be able to adjust the position to center the title. Inside the text controls, you can also adjust the highlight text. Here, I would like to get only book in gray, so I will adjust the right on end value. You have full control over the color of that highlight as well as the opacity. Here, I will keep it white with a semi-transparent value. Beneath that, inside the elements controls, we have control over the shadow parameter, where you can adjust the strength, angle, distance, and blur of that asset. To complete this shot, I want to add a line graph. And for that, we've got a few different options. I'll decide to go with line graph 1. I will drag that over my clip and line that up so it begins just before the end of my title. I'll also trim the end to match with the end of the clip. In the preset controls, I will reduce the global size and move the graph down just a little. Inside the line controls, you will be able to customize both lines. You can adjust the gradient and modify each color inside that gradient. Each of these lines are defined by 3 points, and by modifying the X and Y position of those points, you can either keep your lines nice and straight or add more or less of a curve to your line. Inside the chart controls, you will get access to the X and Y axes of the graph, where you can adjust their height and width, as well as the labels you want on each axis. Next, I will add a third element. But first, I will reduce the size of the tracks inside the timeline by just a little. So next, I will add a layout preset over the graph. And to position this layout, I will use the controls directly inside the viewer. To do that, I will select the Fusion Overlay option and move the layout to the top right. Of course, you can always refine the position inside the inspector if you want. And next, I will adjust the gradient to add in a little more pink. For the next shot, I will add a text block. I'll drag it over my clip, and I will slide it over to the left and pull it down a little as well. Inside the text controls, I can add any text I want. Just like that first title we added, we can select the range of the highlight we need with the right on, start, end parameter. I would like to change the color of this highlight to a light purple to go along with the regular text in white. Now, to smooth the cut between this shot and the next one, I will add a transition. mKeynote provides 8 transitions with various effects. I'm going to select transition 3, and this transition will create a flashing effect. I can simply drag and drop the transition over the cut to apply that, and inside the inspector, you will always be able to define the duration, but depending on the specific transition you select, you will also have additional controls to customize your effect. For this transition, I can adjust the contrast, the gain, and the brightness to give my transition a unique look. For the next shot, I want to add title 4. I will quickly customize it by adjusting the position, editing the text, and modifying the color of the gradient. But you can also add more colors to your gradient. The gradient parameter is very flexible, as you can push each color position beyond the limit of the graph inside the inspector. Inside the elements controls, I will adjust the drop shadow effect. To complete this title, I will add a call to action preset. There are 10 call to action presets inside mKeynote. I'll select preset 8 and I will adjust that position. Now, there are many customization options for the call to action presets. The main button can be switched from one solid color to a gradient. You can also customize the cursor. You can select a regular arrow, a circle, or you can create an interaction with the button below by changing the button color. On the next shot, I will add a text cloud preset. I'll customize that by quickly editing the position and the text. And I'll also disable the shadow. Next, I would like to add a logo animation. There are 3 logo animations available. I'm going to select logo number 2. Inside the logo controls, you will be able to switch between logo mode or text mode. But here I would like to import my own logo, so I will select logo and click on the browse button. I can select my logo, which is this PNG file. Then I will adjust the gradient's color. And with the outline range parameter, I can also increase the outlines. This is all right, but I would like to decrease the background details to help draw attention to the logo. To do that, I will add a background effect. Preset background 6 will be perfect for this, as it will blur the background. In order to apply the effect on both elements, the video background and the text cloud preset, I will use an adjustment clip. I have the adjustment clip effect saved as a favorite, so I have easy and direct access at any time. I can drag that between my logo and the text cloud presets, and I will drag my background effect number 6 onto that adjustment clip. Perfect. Now my logo is much more readable. For the last shot, I would like to create a composition. First, I'll need to create a background element. I could use a new adjustment clip like we did on the previous shot, but here I will apply my effects directly onto the clip. First, I will convert my clip into a compound clip to normalize the duration for the effect. Then I will duplicate it by holding the Option key and dragging it to a new track. Then I will disable the copy temporarily by pressing the D key. Onto that compound clip, I will drag and drop background preset number 4. I can start to customize this preset by making sure my compound clip is selected, going to the inspector, and opening the Effects tab. The first thing I'll do is remove the in and out animation using those checkboxes. With the background preset, you can limit the background inside the zone with the bar controls. And you can customize any part of the background element. For example, here I can decrease the luminance value of the blue channel. Finally, in the effects controls, you can add more or less grain. That's looking good for the background element. We can move on. Next, I will enable that copy of the compound clip by pressing the D key again. On this clip, I'm going to add one of the 15 placeholder effects in mKeynote. I will select the placeholder's preset number 8 and drag it onto my compound clip. As you can see, this preset will use 4 drop zone elements, and by default, nothing happens. Let's open the effects tab to check out the parameters we have access to. Inside the media controls, we have access to 4 drop zone parameters. If you've already tried some plugins for MotionVFX for DaVinci Resolve, you may know that these drop zone elements are limited to images or image sequences. No video files allowed. But our amazing developers have built these presets around this limitation to allow you to effectively use video clips on your timeline in place of those drop zones. In the controls for this effect, you have the option to select video or photo. In this case, if I select video for drop zone 4, it will display the video inside the drop zone. Of course, here we have 4 drop zones, so I will move up the clip inside the timeline and create space for the 3 other clips, which will become their own drop zone. By pressing the Option key, I can quickly duplicate the previous shots from our timeline and drag them below our effect. As they all have various global durations, I will convert them all to compound clips so that they all have the same duration and avoid some synchronization problems within the stacked effects. Next, on each video layer, I will add the same effect, placeholders 8, and begin to customize each version by selecting the top clip. Inside the media controls, I will disable all the drop zones except number 4. Then I will select the clip below that, where I will disable all the drop zones except drop zone number 3, making sure that on that drop zone 3, I selected that same video option. I will repeat that process for the remaining 2 video clips, setting the next to drop zone 2 and the final to drop zone 1, disabling all the others and making sure that both of those active drop zones are set to video. To simplify the timeline, I can then select all 4 clips and create a compound clip to group them all. I will then adjust the position of the compound clip, shifting that to the right. And to complete this composition, I will add a list preset. I'm going to go with list preset 3, and I will also add the small details preset. With this preset, you get access to many icons, including ticks, an arrow, line, or dot. Here I will select the arrow, and I will adjust the position on the left of the list. I'll scale that up a bit, and we are done. As you've just seen, mKeynote provides many different elements you can combine in limitless ways to showcase your content with a beautiful and clean design produced with Apple's guidelines. Remember that besides DaVinci Resolve, mKeynote is also available for Final Cut Pro and Adobe Premiere. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to write us a comment below. For more information, go to motionvfx.com and don't forget to subscribe to stay updated on future releases. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.